afternoon, everyone. Welcome to the St. Augustine Alligator Farm, and welcome to our feeding demonstration. My name is Liz, and I'm the newest reptile keeper here, so if it takes me a minute to recognize an individual that's in front of me that I'm trying to feed, just give me a moment. They all look the same. Besides that, I have a couple safety things to go over before I go ahead and start feeding. So these ledges that go all the way across our lagoon are meant to keep everything out. So if we have anything resting on it that's not directly attached to our body, like cups, purses, children, we want to go ahead and keep those up and off of that. Because I know accidents do happen and things fall in. We want to keep our alligators as safe as possible. That being said, I know things happen. So if anything does happen to fall in, just let the nearest staff member know as soon as possible. We'll try to get that out as soon as possible for you. Besides that, I have plenty of edible things for our alligators here, and they are ready for me. So we're going to go ahead and start off with a nice Missouri croc chow. Now, this may not look like much to you, but this is a fully nutritional, balanced diet for them. You'll better know their parent company, Purina. Yes, it's the same company that makes your dog food at home, makes our food for our alligators here. This food was created by crocodilian biologists, vets, and our own staff here. And you'll also notice that not everybody's coming over, and this is just a snack for these alligators. So they get multiple snacks a day and throughout the week, and they might not be too hungry, so they don't have to come over if they don't want to. That's not the only thing I brought up here with me. I also have some nice, juicy wraps. Now, these wraps offer a really nice balance in addition to the pelleted diet. So anything we can't fit in there, like that skin, bone, fur, anything like that, it adds a really nice enrichment as well as a nice addition to their diet. Now, it takes me a minute to get their attention because most of the time they get really, really excited for this diet of the pelleted food. Let's see if Casey wants to come up here and get some rats today. Come on, Casey. 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 You look very pretty, but you're not gonna jump for it, are you? All right, that's okay. Hi, Bob. Come on, Bob. Bob. Good job, bud. So while I'm trying to find the attention of another alligator to feed, I'll tell you a little of history of our facility. We're actually not standing in the original location. We're actually originally located across the street in 1893. But unfortunately, due to some forest fires and flooding, we had to relocate to where we are all standing now. In the 1930s, the Drysdale family took over and brought us to not only having American alligators, but also 24 species of crocodilian, all the birds, mammals, and the other reptiles that you see here today. So we've been around a very long time, and for over 125 years, we've been supporting wildlife conservation, education, and improving our animal welfare. And you guys can always help out too. If you have any questions at all, our website has great resources, and we are all great resources as well here, so. All right. Who are you? Brooke, do you want to try to get some rats? Brooke. Come on, Brooke. You're so close. Come on. Come on, Brooke. Brooke, you are so close. Brooke. All right. Bob, you already got one, and I know you're going to try to steal it. We got Walker over here, and let's see if Walker wants to come over here and get one. Good job. So alligators are generalist carnivores, which means if it's made out of meat, it's good for them to eat. Now they're not always going to start out eating bigger prey items like these rats, rabbits, or even deer. They're going to start out eating smaller things like little crickets or lizards. Once they do upgrade to these bigger prey items, you're kind of noticing right now how they're just swallowing these rats whole. But once they do upgrade to deers or anything bigger, they're not going to be able to swallow it whole. They're going to have to break it into smaller pieces. So they're going to take their 70 to 80 conical teeth, grab onto those prey items, do that nice 360 death roll, and break it down so they can throw it back and just swallow it. Chip. Come on, Chip. Come on. So you also notice how big these alligators are and can get. They actually don't eat as much as you think they would. They actually only eat around 80 to 90 pounds of meat per year. And to put that in perspective, that's about one sandwich a week for us. Now that isn't a lot, and that's because they are ectotherms or cold-blooded, which means that they regulate their body temperature with outside sources like the sun and the water. So they're not burning in as many calories as we think we would. All right, Mama. You want to come up here and try to get a rat? Mama. All right, she is not going to want to go for it, but I guess Casey wants to get some right now as well. All right, you guys are going to have to hold on a second because you guys are already in your tube queue. While I'm waiting for them to kind of settle down a little bit, I'll tell you a little bit more about them. So you kind of see how I'm trying to get them up and out of that water and calling individual names. And that's because they can actually jump 2/3 of their body length out of the water using all the condensed lateral muscle in their tails and back legs. Now that is a nice leap and jump. And as you can tell, if I'm sticking my arm down there, there is a lot of heads that could possibly snag me. So we always want to just be careful with working with them and be very conscious. You guys seem to settle down quickly. Thank you very much. Stalker, do you want some? You want to get a rat today? Good job, Stalker. Alrighty, I am on to my last couple prey items, and we brought some nice juicy chickens out today for you. And that comes with a couple different facts that we have. And as I'm calling their names, and they do recognize their names, and they're lifting up their heads and thinking, oh, that's me, I'm gonna get that food item. And that's because they do truly know their name. They have a true cerebral cortex, which means that it's the same part of the brain as we do use for reasoning and critical thinking. All right, Bluto, you wanna come up here and try to get this chicken? Come on, Bluto. Come on. No? You were so close. Come on, Bluto. Bluto. No? All right, that's okay. Hi, Mama. Alrighty, one more chicken to give out. I wish Hunter would come over here. He is one of our largest alligators in the lagoon. He's right back here. He comes in at 13 feet long and about 700 pounds. Now, I did say he's almost the largest. We do have another very large alligator in here. He's normally hanging out in the back. All right, who wants this chicken? You already got one. You can't come back up here, you gotta share. All right, Chip, you want? Chip. You're so close. Good job. Alrighty, like I said, that was my last prey item for today. If you have any questions at all, I'll be hanging out up here. Otherwise, our next show is over in our theater at 1 o'clock as our Scales and Tails. Hope to see you guys there and enjoy the rest of your day.
I wish I had seen that children. It's exactly like dog food. Thank you.
like baby floss.
A baby
give him a few.
They just get a stir.
You're not scared? Where'd it go?
Yeah, we did see that.
Yeah, here's bigger ones.
big long nose on it. What do y'all think? Looks like a dog.
Oh.
I don't know.
Is
Thank you. wish we're gonna get them before you guys are going to sleep.
When he came out of the water, he just had a massive head. It was all dinosaur.
Gobek's story begins on the Fly River in southern New Guinea, a large island.
Living up in the hills and along the river. It simply has not been touched.
Gobek had become a legend. Craig came to New Guinea to hunt saltwater crocodiles. The animals were prized for their skins and used to make shoes, briefcases, and handbags.
You lost it. So, in the case of Gobek, I set the hook, pulled the line up, and the hook was out. But the croc was still there. And as we pulled it, he knew something was going on, and all the grass was moving, and I thought, oh, I don't know where he's going to go. The hook's not there, there's nothing attaching to it.
In 1989, the alligator was purchased.
Would you like to see that?
Brought him home to Ceylon. He was given to a pool surrounded by natural vegetation that grows. Visitors could view Gobek from below the water.
Well, this is a different
game.
I'm certain that it's a positive thing, but it may not always be a positive thing for the
people.
You're either the guy that's doing something the crocodile really likes, and they always come towards you, or if you're the guy always doing something crocodiles don't like, and they're getting angry at you. So I don't know which I like being.
observing or check and managing behaviors.
What we didn't know was how long it would take an animal from south of the equator to adjust to being in our seasons. And it turns out it only took her a year.
The Komodo dragon. He needs a boat and a sense of adventure.